Assalamu alaikum and hi again everyone. So in this video, saya akan terangkan everything about deductive argument. Okay, so if you still remember the previous videos, deductive argument is when from general statement, kita go to specifics. Okay. So, from general to specific is deductive argument. So, in this video, I will cover three learning outcomes. So, the first one is how we determine and justify the validity. So, kita nak identify sama ada deductive argument ini adakah dia valid ataupun tidak. And yang kedua, to determine whether the valid argument is sound. So, learning outcome pertama dan kedua ada kaitan. So, bila argument tu kita dah identify sebagai deductive, and then kita identify dia valid, kemudian baru kita identify sama adakah dia sound ataupun tidak. If it is not valid, then kita tak perlu determine whether it is sound. Okay, lastly, saya akan masuk adalah how we form a valid deductive argument. Okay, macam mana kita nak buat deductive argument supaya dia jadi valid ? Okay, so without further ado, kita akan pergi kepada learning outcome yang pertama dan yang kedua. Alright, deductive argument ada tiga bentuk. So kita ada form 1, bentuk yang pertama, form 2 and form 3. So you have 3 forms of deductive argument. Okay, so di setiap form, kita ada premise 1, kita ada premise 2, and then kita akan ada conclusion. Jadi, kalau kamu tengok, for example, form 1, so these forms are definite lah. Tidak boleh ditukar. This is like a formula lah. Okay, form 1, all A are B. A and B refers to a statement. Okay. A dan B adalah satu statement sebenarnya. So, A is one statement. B is one statement. So, premise 2, C is A. So, C is another statement. And then the conclusion says C is B. So, in form 1, you have 3 statements. So, statement A, statement B, statement C. Okay, jadi form 1 ini, deductive argument dia mesti susun atur dia begini. Alright? So, form 2, if P then Q. So, in this case, P and Q is actually statements. Okay? So, ini adalah implication. If you still remember, if then, kita punya implication. So, dia kata, premise kedua, P is true. Then, conclusion Q, statement Q will be true. So, form 3, the premise 1 dia in sama juga macam form 2. However, premise 2 and the conclusion, the difference is dia punya negation. Not. Okay? So, form 3, what you have to remember, dia adalah negation. Form 2 and 3 adalah implication. Alright? So, if you see kedudukan dia, in form 2, premise 2, P is true, conclusion Q is true. However, in form 3, dia start with, in premise 2, it starts with Q, not P. Okay? So, not Q is true. So, dia negatkan kita punya Q. Alright? So, let's do a few exercise. So, let's see exercise 1. Alright, so premise 1. All actresses are good at dancing. So, ni kata kunci yang paling utama. Which is all. Sebab in our 3 forms, hanya ada satu sahaja form yang ada perkataan all. Okay. So, of course, kita dah ada clue bahawa this is actually form 1. Okay, let's look. So, all actresses are good at dancing. So, kita kena identify apa statement A kita, apa statement B. So, here, statement A will be actresses. B akan jadi good at dancing. A ni B. And then, premise 2, kita akan ada satu benda yang baru, C. Jasmine is an actress. See, actress A, dia berulang kembali. Dan kali ni kita ada Jasmine, which is C. Alright, and then conclusion, C is B. So, C, Jasmine is good at dancing, B. So, ni adalah Jasmine. Good at dancing is B. So, confirm. Kita punya exercise yang pertama ni adalah daripada form 1. So, from here, kita akan bagi tahu this is valid. Alright? So, itu satu cara nak tahu sama ada dia valid atau tidak is make sure everything susun atau dia sama seperti form dia di atas ni. Okay? Dia mesti susun atur dia sama seperti di form yang kita pilih. Sekiranya susun atur dia tidak mengikut form di atas, so it is not valid. Okay. So now kita nak identify whether dia adalah sound or not. Sound eh? Sebab sekarang dah valid. Okay. Sekarang kita nak kena identify setiap premise and conclusion sama ada dia true or false. Okay, you have to determine true or false for each statement. Okay, all actresses are good at dancing. So, Jasmine is an actress. Okay, so Jasmine is good at dancing. So, this is true. True, true lah. So, jadi my mistake. This one cannot be true. Why? It's because kita tak boleh nak cakap all actresses are good at dancing. Okay, we don't know. Sebab ada je actresses that is not good at dancing. So, this will be false. Not all actresses are good at dancing. Okay. So, now, bila kita tengok, okay, satu cara nak tahu, bila kita tengok the truth value for each statement ni, kalau ada false sahaja, so maksudnya it is not sound. Okay. Untuk identify whether it is sound or not, semua statement ini mesti true. It must be true, everything. Kalau dia ada false, so it is not sound. Okay, that's how you determine. Okay. Let's do another one. Okay. So now again, the second exercise starts with all. Okay. So starts with all. So, it is form 1. So, again, actresses is A. Good at dancing is B. And then, Jasmine is C. Tapi, you see, good at dancing is B. See? Dia tak sama dengan premise 2 kita. So, premise 2 is supposed to be C is A. So, now Jasmine, C is B. So, bila dia tidak ikut, automatically we say this is not valid. Okay? So, dia tak follow form. So, it is not valid. Alright, let's do another one. We're going to do a few so that you can see. Alright. So, this is the third one. Okay. So, now perkataan if, then. So, we have two. If, then. So, kita ada either form 1, form 2 or form 3. Sebab dia menggunakan premise 1, dia menggunakan if, then. Alright, so we identify. So, W less than 9 is P. Okay, W less than 19 is Q. Alright, so premise 2, kamu tengok premise 2, W digantikan dengan 4, which is less than 9. Sama eh, diikut dengan P. So this, premise 2 is actually P is true sebab dia ikut. Inequality dia ikut seperti P di atas, cuma digantikan W kepada 4. Kenapa dia buat macam tu? Sebab ini adalah deductive. Daripada general kepada specific. Jadi W dia mesti specific. And then conclusion, if you see, W still guna pakai. Tapi dia guna Q punya. Less than 19. So this is actually Q is true. So automatically we can say this is actually form 2. Di mana P is true, Q is true. Dan dia memang ikut susun atur. So, we say this is valid. Alright, sekarang nak tahu dia sound ataupun tidak. Okay. If W is less than 9. Okay. W less than 9, then W less than 19. Of course, true. This is true. Okay, so 4 is less than 9. Yes, true. 4 is less than 19. True. So, you have 3 true. So, we can say this is a valid and sound argument. Okay, this is a valid and sound deductive argument. Alright, so ni tak ada masalah menentukan truth value. So, ini logik eh. Sekiranya W tu satu nombor is less than 9, of course, dia akan less than 19. Confirm. Alright, let's do another last one. Another one. Okay. So, this is another one. Right. So, again, start dengan if, then. If, and then. Okay. So, this is sama ada form 2 ataupun form 3. Okay. So, let's look. Kita punya P is A not equal to 0. This is my P. And then, A, X, and ini adalah is a quadratic expression. So, this is my Q. Alright, let's look. Premise 2. Premise 2, they start dengan A is not equals to 0. So, they follow P. They follow P, eh? Jadi, bila they follow P, so ni maksudnya P is true. Okay, so nampak kan? Dia sebenarnya adalah form 2. Okay, let's check conclusion. So, ni sama dengan Q is a quadratic expression. So, dia pun follow Q is true. Okay, jadi kita boleh kata this is actually form 2. Valid ke tak valid? Yes, it is valid. Sebab dia follow, form 2 dia follow. Okay, let's look at the truth value. So, if A is not equals to 0, okay, A can be any number, any integer, positive, negative, decimal, fraction. So, then AX to the power of N plus BX plus C is a quadratic expression. Okay, quadratic expression. Adakah ini betul? So, A is not equals to 0. So, kita tak boleh cakap kerana N ini tidak ada nilai. You see, the value of N here has no value. Quadratic expression merujuk kepada the highest power is 2. So, kat sini dia tak letak nombor 2. So, N ni can be any number. So, this is false. Okay, melainkan dia letak N tu adalah 2. And then, dia kata premise A is not equal to 0. Okay, true, no problem. So, ni is a quadratic equation. So, of course lah, it is false. So, bila you tengok, ada 2 false. 1, 2. So, this is not sound. Okay, dia valid sebagai deductive argument, tapi it is not sound. Okay, that is how you identify sama ada premise-premise ni valid dan juga sama ada dia sound ataupun tidak. Okay, alright, let's look at our third. Kita punya third learning outcome. How we form a valid deductive argument. Okay. So, here I have a few questions. Kita pergi kepada question terus. Alright. So, forming a valid deductive argument, seperti saya kata sebelum ni, kita nak identify deductive argument tu valid ataupun tidak, dia mesti ikut form 1, form 2 ataupun form 3. Okay. Jadi, soalan akan bagi kamu macam bentuk ni lah. Di mana dia akan kosongkan salah satu. Okay, sama ada premise 1, premise 2 ataupun conclusion dia akan kosongkan. Okay, seperti contoh kat bawah ni lah, dia kosongkan. Alright, sekarang tugas kita adalah kita kena kenal pasti sama ada dia adalah form 1, form 2 atau form 3. Okay, let's look again. Kalau form 1, saya patut guna pensel warna lain kot. Form 1, tak boleh. Okay, dia mesti all A is B, kan? Lepas tu, C is A, and then C is B. Form 2 pula, dia adalah if P, then Q, right? And then, dia mesti P is true, Q is true. Right, form 3 pula, if P, then Q, tapi dia start dengan negation Q, Q not true, and then P not true juga. Negation, Alright. So, ini adalah kita punya 3 form. Oh, tak nampak ni. Form ketiga. Alright. So, let's look. A. Question A, Kamu kena write conclusion dia. Start dengan perkataan all. Automatically, senang. So, all adalah F1. So, sekarang kita kena identify kita punya A, B dan C. So, all whole numbers are real numbers. So, whole numbers adalah A. Real numbers adalah B. And then, dekat premise 2, 38. So, 38 benda baru. So, this is C. It's a whole number. Whole number adalah A. So, C is A. Jadi, C. Conclusion start dengan C. So, 38 is B. Is a real number. Okay, that's how you do it lah. Okay, so dia akan follow macam tu je lah. So, 38C. Real number adalah kita punya B. Alright, let's look at B. So, now dia datang dengan if then. So, yang pertama apa ni? Adalah kita punya P. Belakang ni is our Q. Okay, and then premise 2 dia specific. Nilai A adalah 2. B adalah P. C adalah negative 2. Alright, has real roots. See ya? Saya tulis. A digantikan dengan 2. B digantikan dengan P. Okay, C digantikan dengan negative 2. And then has real roots. Has. Tengok, dia tak ada negation. Dia tak cakap not real roots ke apa. Jadi, ni adalah P is true. Jadi, dia akan follow F2. So, sekarang kita kena buat Q is true. So, kena gantikan. Apa nilai B kita? B kita adalah P. So, P square minus 4. A adalah 2. C is negative 2. Greater and equal to 0. Tapi ini bukan jawapan akhir. Kamu boleh je simplify kan. Tak ada masalah. So, dia boleh jadi 4 square, P square plus 16 greater and equals to 0. Okay. So, that is my conclusion. So, dia akan follow F2. Yang pertama tadi F1. Okay, let's look at C. So, again, dia ada if then. So, kita identify straight line y equals to mx plus c is parallel to the x-axis adalah p. M equals to 0 is q. And then, kamu tengok dia start dengan q. And then, not equals to 0. So, maksudnya dia negation q. Okay, so ni sebenarnya adalah dia negate q. Jadi, saya kena negatekan P. Alright. So, saya kena buat lah. Straight line. Straight line. Y equals to mx plus c is not parallel to the x-axis. So, ada perkataan not untuk negatekan dia. Okay, so far, senang. Sebab ada premise 1, ada premise 2. So, senang nak buat conclusion. Okay, cuba tengok. Ini susah sikit. Alright. So, sekarang kita tengok A. Tidak ada premise 1. So, saya tak tahu. Dia if then ke, dia ada all ke, tak tahu. Okay, let's look at premise 2. 37. So, ada 37. conclusion pun ada 37. And then kita ada prime number. And then kita ada only two factors. So kalau kamu tengok form kita ada 3. Hanya form 1 sahaja di mana premise 2 dan conclusion dia berulang. CC. Jadi ini sebenarnya adalah form 1. This is form 1. Okay, so jadi 37 is actually C. So C is A. So prime number adalah A. Only two factors adalah B. So jadi kita akan start dengan all A, all prime numbers. Okay. Has only two factors. Okay, settle. All A is B. Alright, let's look at question B. So, dia start dengan if then. So, sama ada form 2 ataupun form 3. And then, kita identify annual sales of A and C company exceeds 3 million. So, ni adalah P. And then, the employees get a bonus of 3 months salary. Q. Alright, it's premise 2 tak ada. Conclusion. The annual sales of A and C company. Nampak eh? Sama dengan P. Tapi, do not exceed. Ada perkataan do not. Jadi, ni sebenarnya adalah negation untuk P. Jadi, dia adalah form 3 yang ada negation. So, premise 2 adalah negation Q. So, tengok kat Q. So, kita salin balik. The employees. Okay. Get a bonus. Jadi, did not get a bonus of 3 months salary. Alright. Okay, last. C. If, then. So, X equals to K. Is my P. K is the root of the equation. Blah, 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 blah. Is my Q. So, kalau kamu tengok conclusion. K dia gantikan dengan 9. And then, not equal. So, this means dia negatkan P. So, once again, dia adalah form yang ketiga. So, kita nak negatkan ni. Tengok eh. Dia dah tukarkan K kepada 9. So, you have to change. So, 9 is not a root of the equation 3x squared minus 5 equals to 12. Okay. So, tu sahajalah. That's how you do it. Alright. So, we have covered our 3 learning outcomes. So, to determine and justify validity. So, nak justify validity, dia mesti berdasarkan 3 forms ni. Okay. So, nak tahu dia sound atau tidak, first kena valid dulu. Kalau dia tak valid, tak payah tentukan. Bila dia valid, nak tentukan sound, kita kena tengok daripada truth value dia. Okay, semua premise dengan conclusion mesti true. Kalau salah satu tidak true, jadi dia tidak sound. Not sound. Everything has to be true to be sound. Okay, and then thirdly, kita form a valid deductive argument. Jadi senang, dia refer balik kepada our 3 forms. Okay, that's all for deductive argument. I'll see you guys in the next video. for inductive argument. Bye guys.